Since 1990, we have spent millions of euros and tens of thousands of research hours to find scientific answers to life's most important and challenging questions. What makes us happy? What makes us healthy? How can we heal from physical and mental disease? How can we heal emotionally and sexually so we can be happy in our relationships? How can we develop our talents and be of value to the world? We have interviewed more than 15,000 people and asked more than 4,000 different questions. After 20 years of intensive research, we are beginning to find the answers we have been looking for so long. We have already presented these answers in 250 research papers and about 30 books. Now, bring it all to you. In this paper, Professor Anderson, Professor Candle, and myself are trying to make the public understand the problems associated with being a leading researcher in alternative medicine. Many of our colleagues have experienced big problems. In Sweden, a wonderful man and brilliant researcher, Bengt Lindström, has experienced big problems with his research in Antonovsky and spontaneous healing of mental disease in children. In Germany, we have the old story about Ulrike Hammer, who was prosecuted for making a non-drug treatment of cancer. In America, we have had Dean Ornish. I saw Dean Ornish almost crying at a conference many years ago, where he complained of the treatment he received from other doctors when he presented his science on alternative treatment of heart disease and now also cancer. In general, many of the leading researchers have been threatened or have their safety or integrity compromised by attacks. In America, a professor who was organizing an international conference in holistic medicine has had child pornography placed on his computer, and he was turned into the police. The police came, but they could see that that the files has just been installed there just before they were called, so they didn't believe it. There are also stories from England, where Tom Jefferson in the Lancet wrote that the critical article about how the influenza vaccine was tested, and he claimed that it wasn't tested in a valid way, and he told me that he got death threats on his email from the company. There are so many of these stories where leading researchers, either if they are presenting alternatives to the traditional medicine, or if they are criticizing traditional medicine, are getting into big problems. It's very much like a James Bond movie, or the Danish researcher Peter Gøtzsche is talking about the pharmaceutical industry as a mafia. I wouldn't call it a mafia, because I don't believe it is organized on that level, and that they're working together, and that they're that criminal, like a mafia. It's quite rare that the researchers are really killed and murdered, but it's very, very normal that they are framed and destroyed by rumors and these kind of actions. So we encourage all nations to be aware of this problem and to protect their scientists, especially in holistic and alternative medicine, because these scientists obviously need much more protection than they have today.